Hello everyone, I am Akshay Kumar and you all are watching The Sedative Doctor. So in this video, we are going to discuss about left ventricular systolic dysfunction in English. Our video explaining the same topic in Hindi is already live on the channel. You can check it out. I will put the link of that video in the description box or I will pin it in the comment section too. Many of you had requested about the English version of this video, so here it is. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. So let's move on to the topic, left ventricular systolic dysfunction, LVST. But before focusing on the disease LVST, let's discuss about the normal functioning and the normal structure of the human heart. Human heart has four chambers. Two are smaller chambers known as atrium and two comparatively larger chambers are called ventricles. Right side of the heart has one smaller and one larger chambers that are named as right atrium and right ventricle, and the same applies to the left side also, that is left atrium and left ventricle. But here we will discuss mainly about the left ventricle because this LVST is a condition, is a case of left ventricle only. Okay, so left ventricle has a major role inside our body. It pumps the oxygenated blood, it pumps the pure blood throughout the body. During the pumping, the heart contracts and relaxes. The contraction of heart is termed as systole and the relaxation is termed as diastole. And here the name of the disease is left ventricular systolic dysfunction. It means that there is something wrong with the systole of the left ventricle, that there is something wrong with the contraction of the left ventricle. Generally, when the left ventricle systoles, the blood gets pumped out from the heart to reach each and every location of the body. Due to its pumping force, the blood gets transported to each and every location of the human body. But if due to any reason, the left ventricle will not systole properly or contract properly, then the normal amount of blood will not be pumped out from the left ventricle. And if a sufficient amount of blood will not be pumped out from the left ventricle, it will lead to a lot of problems in each and every part of the body. This can be due to some persisting heart conditions like myocardial infarction, also known as heart attack, left ventricular hypertrophy, hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, obstructive cardiomyopathy, and so on. In all these cases, LVST is very, very, very common. We can say that LVST is a complication of this persisting disease. Let's move on to the symptoms of LVST. In a general condition, the left ventricle pumps the blood that is rich in oxygen. This oxygen-rich blood is very, very important for the proper functioning and energy of the body. But here in LVST, the left ventricle is not systoling properly, it is not contracting properly. And due to this, less blood will be pumped out, that will further lead to less oxygen supply in the body. And due to the less oxygen supply, the patient can suffer from tiredness, extreme tiredness, fatigue, dyspnea means the shortness of breath. Then angina pain means heart pain. The patient will suffer from severe heart or chest pain, and the patient's respiratory rate will increase, the patient's pulse rate will increase, the patient's heart rate will also increase. This LVST condition can further complicate to different diseases such as arrhythmia, recurrent myocardial infarction, or it can also lead to death of the patient. For diagnosis, we can proceed with the echocardiography because echocardiography is the best way to diagnose LVST in any patient. In echocardiography report, the ejection fraction of the heart will be very low. Ejection fraction is the amount of the blood that is being pumped from the left ventricle after each systole, after each contraction. So the ejection fraction of the left ventricle will be very low. Apart from echocardiography, we can also proceed with ECG to know the electrical conductivity of the heart, cardiac MRI, drop T test, or some routine blood tests. And for treatment, we can use the drugs of beta blocker groups, ACE inhibitors, diuretics, calcium channel blockers, etc. But we will also focus on the root cause of LVST. If the LVST is due to the heart attack or myocardial infarction, then we will deal with the heart attack and myocardial infarction. If it is due to some hypertrophic cardiomyopathy, then we will deal with the hypertrophic cardiomyopathy along with this LVST. So this was a short and simple discussion of LVST in English language. If you like this discussion, then don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And if you want English videos, English discussions on different topics, then you can comment me below. I will try to upload the videos in English and Hindi both. Okay, so we'll see you guys in the next video. Till then, be happy and be safe.